hell, and is heaven to him. Thou hast answered right, please do, and thou shalt live. But he willing to justify himself, said unto Jesus, and who is my neighbor? And Jesus said, a certain man went down from Jerusalem to Jericho, and fell among thieves, who stripped him of his raiment, and wounded him, and departed, giving him half dead. And by chance there came down a certain priest that way, and when he saw him, he passed by on the other side. And likewise, a Levite, when he was at the place, he looked at him, and passed by on the other side. But a certain Samaritan, as he turned, came where he was, and when he saw him, he had compassion on him, and went to him, and bound up his wounds, pouring in oil and wine, and set him onto his own beast, and brought him to an inn, and took care of him. And on the morrow, when he departed, he took out two pence, and gave them to the host, and said unto him, take care of him, and whatsoever thou spendest more, when I come again, I will repay thee. Which now of these three thinkest thou was neighbor unto him that fell among the thieves? And he said, he that showed mercy on him. Then Jesus said unto him, go, and do thou likewise. For being a woman, we forgot to see you to a suggestion of it. Thank you. правда, видим заимствовать по преступству, и прочие беззакония прекратятся, истинная же любовь, да царствует в сердцах наших, молитесь о Спасителе наш, услыши и милостивно, помилуй. Нуждающихся в моей
Thank you. word for our edification, and to join our prayers with the rest of our parish family and raise those to heaven for God's glory. We're commanded to gather each week on the first day of the week, which is today, according to the way the church sees things, which is Saturday, the last day. Sunday is the first day, the day of the resurrection, to celebrate our Lord's resurrection in meeting. Today, we commemorate the apostle and evangelist Matthew, and we heard about him a lot in the services last night, a little bit today. But we also have a reading from Luke, from the 10th chapter. And this is the famous parable of the Good Samaritan. And I think this temptation, when we know the gospel, when we've heard it before, when we could almost say it ourselves, is to begin to make our shopping list. And as we hear it begin, I know this one, I don't have to pay attention. I know this one, I don't have to pay attention to the sermon. And I mean, I sympathize with you about the sermon, but the gospel, we really need to be attentive and hear what it is that's being read to us. Because I hate to pull back the curtain too much and let you in on any really big secrets. Actually, there are no secrets in the church. We read the same gospels every year, right? It's not like Father Gregory sits down at the beginning of the year and says, okay, we read that one 3 years in a row, it's out now, let's put something in. It's not my choice, right? That's above me. I don't make that decision. What's read is established by the church. And so, not only do we hear this gospel every year, essentially, not quite, but essentially every gospel that we hear on every Sunday we hear every year. We just don't pay such attention. Or we pay better attention because we don't know those as well as we know this one. It's important to understand the context of the gospel. We're reading from the 10th chapter of Matthew. There are essentially three things that happened in this chapter, and it's really important to understand the other two if we're going to understand this parable of the Good Samaritan. In the beginning of the chapter, the Lord sends out his disciples so they can preach. You guys can stand up. You're big. You're strong. Don't put out chairs now while we're in the sun. Sermon, just stand and listen and pay attention. Don't walk around. The Lord sends out the apostles. He tells them what it is that they are to do. All they are to live is his disciples. And he makes it very clear when you read that, that being a disciple of Christ also means action. It means work. It means there are things that you need to do. It's not a hypothetical or an abstract conceptualization. It's a call to action. So he sends them out, two by two, so on and so forth. They go to where the Lord is going to preach. They come back to him. Oh, even the devils are subject to, you know, to us by your name, and so on and so forth. And he says, listen, don't worry so much about that. Just be thankful that your names are written in heaven. But go out and work to spread the kingdom of heaven. Then after this parable of the Good Samaritan, we hear about Martha and Mary. Again, immediately all ears closed, because I know this one. I don't need to be told about anything about this. I know everything. Okay, well, just walk with me a little bit here on this walk. Martha and Mary, we know that Martha is working, Mary is listening, and they have a kind of a showdown there, and the Lord says, well, you know, it's good to work, but it's also important to be a disciple. And this is the most important thing that Mary has chosen. But the work, there are things that we have to do as disciples of Christ. Right? Sometimes that's sit and listen. Sometimes that's go out and preach. Sometimes that's learn from a parable, which is also going to teach us how we need to live, the action that we need to undertake as disciples of Christ. Right, the beginning of the gospel, we know this, love the Lord with all your mind, all your heart, all your soul, all your strength, and your neighbor is yourself. And the Lord says to the lawyer who's tempting him, that's right. And he says, well, who is my neighbor? And then he tells the parable. Now, in order to get even what's happening here, to see the great irony that the Lord is using here, the very strong irony, maybe that's why we remember it so well. The man is speaking, he's left on the side of the road, half dead. Comes down a priest. Right? This should be like the person who is study for the Old Testament, you know, like you should be a righteous person, and he passes by. Doesn't mean look, doesn't want to have anything to do with that issue. Then comes a Levite. The priests come from the tribe of the Levites in the Old Testament. So this is why we're, it's again like somebody who could be a priest. No, he walks by. Then comes a Samaritan. And if we don't understand the situation with Samaritans and Jews, we may read the gospel and think, man, those Samaritans, those are incredible people. Like, they belong and stuff. Actually, it was totally the opposite. And that's the irony here. The Jews hated those people because they were kind of half Jews and half pagans. And it's just like us. Like, we can be very kind to some stranger in the street, but to our brother, sister, or cousin, like, we'll have this feud that lasts for 50 years. The same thing is true here. Like, these are kind of half Jews, and they just hated them. And they had a terrible reputation. And so when we see that the Samaritan is the one that takes care of the guy and brings him to the inn and pours wine and oil on his wounds and all of this stuff, the irony is just dripping from this when the Lord is telling us. It's obvious that there's strong irony being used here. And then we end the parable essentially with the Lord having a little bit more conversation with the lawyer and saying, you go and do likewise. Do. So the action verb. Do likewise. Be merciful. He asked, who was the one? Was his neighbor. And he says, I guess the one who showed mercy. And he says, you go and do likewise. So the 10th chapter of Luke gives us three examples of what we are supposed to do when we are Christ's disciples. We're striving to be Christ's disciples. We're making some effort in this regard. The gospel is an action-oriented book. It's not just a book to think about, to contemplate, to reflect on. I'm not mocking any of that. That's all important. But if you read the gospel closely, it's obvious that you're supposed to do something. And here the Lord shows us what we are to do. To have mercy. Now, we're supposed to have mercy on strangers, because that's what happened here. Not just strangers. Everyone. And this is a very difficult cross for us. We're good with mercy, like I said, with strangers. But boy, when it comes to family, somehow we forget about the gospel immediately. You know, on the way to Thanksgiving dinner, we might help somebody who's on the side of the road so we can get to Thanksgiving and fight with our family about all the stupid stuff we thought about last year and we'll fight about it. And we forget that we need to show mercy to all. Being a Christian means that you act, that you do. It means that we pray, it means that we come to church, it means that we participate in the sacraments. There's all this action going on. And we also strive to show mercy as we're being taught in today's gospel. So brothers and sisters, I'm going to recommend to you that you would go home today, and before you sort of jump back into the world completely, read the 10th chapter of Luke. See how the Lord explains to those that were around him, but also to us, how it is that we are supposed to act, what we are supposed to do. And if we begin to read the gospel in this way, then we will begin to live like Christians, not just on Sunday morning, but all throughout the week. We will come to this crescendo of the week, which is the Sunday, the Divine Liturgy, and we will take the grace that we find there and bring it out to the world. And that's what we need to do. The world needs God. The world is seeking God. It's trying to fill it with drugs and politics and, you know, all kinds of vices. Well, politics maybe isn't purely a vice, but in any case, all kinds of vices or whatever, trying to fill that hole in the soul where only God can go. And if we can bring out an example of what it is to be a Christian, because the world thinks of Christianity as like hypocrisy. I mean, let's be honest about it. Because a lot of Christians live hypocritical lives. They come to church on Sunday and then they don't live that way. We need to break that paradigm. We need to crush it to dust by living the way we are called to live in the gospel. So let's not fall into the trap, brothers and sisters, of saying, I know this one, I don't need to hear it. I know this one, let me look at it more closely. Maybe I'll learn something this year that I didn't learn last year. Maybe I will learn something that I can put to use today, tomorrow, this week, in my life. And I think that this particular gospel, this gives us a really great opportunity to do that. Go and do likewise. Be merciful. Show mercy. Not hypothetically, not abstractly, but actively. On strangers, on close ones, on everyone that the Lord sends you. And if you do that, then you've already begun to activate the gospel message which you're hearing today. And that can help us to activate the gospel message we read in the rest of the gospel as well. To be a good example to the world, not proudly, but humbly, for the glory of God. If we do that, brothers and sisters, we will also tread the path which leads to the heavenly kingdom. May the Lord grant this to all of us. Amen.
Y
When you come to the city and the door, Please take our weekly bulletin Sunday reading on the voice. We'll have it here for you. If we run off before you get here, you can find it online and post it at noon every single Sunday on our website. The Nativity Fast began already yesterday, and it goes through the end of liturgy on the Feast of the Lord's Nativity, the 25th, according to the church calendar, which is the 7th of January, according to the civil calendar. Special services this week. Wednesday evening, 6 o'clock, we have our Caucus for the Ill. Then Thursday evening at 6 o'clock, and Friday morning at 8 o'clock, we have the Divine Services for the entrance of the Mother of God into the temple. So please take note of that. Those will be in the church. The sign-up sheet is on our website. You also received it in your email if you're on our email list. There will be a special collection today that will come to receive the Act of Art, and that will be for Archbishop Peter's Fund for those in need of assistance. It often happens that people come to the bishop and ask for help, and on this Sunday after Thanksgiving every year, we make a special collection for that, so please be generous when you come to the cross. We have our Learning Orthodoxy class for our catechumens, which happens every Sunday after the Divine Liturgy, but everyone is welcome, and it's in the church, so join us if you can, if you would be interested in learning more about your faith. It's important for us, brothers and sisters, as we talk about in the gospel, to be good examples. And I think that's true as regards to the pandemic as well. I'm tired of it, you're tired of it, everybody's tired of it. If it was only our annoyance that needed to go away, it would be gone and dead, gone and old, but it's not our annoyance that needs to happen. So it's important that we follow the rules and the guidelines so that we keep other people safe. And don't worry only about our own. We'll hear the life of St. Matthew, which is today, momentarily. Are there any other announcements before we hear the life of St. Matthew? Yeah.
Just one quick update for the school, so you know, I'll keep you on the line. We are going to be able to put the ground up to the walkway here. So that's what I at least have the sidewalls put out in the front.
So just to be clear, you may not know this, but we're going to be putting a bigger than a sidewalk, it's actually the road that will come from the parking lot all the way to that way which is being built now, so that we won't have to walk in the grass. So pray for a dry or cold or both for these next couple of weeks until we can get that done. And God willing, we won't have any too money. Any other announcements? Yes, Marina.
On behalf of the kiosk manager, there are some warm alpaca shoe inserts there. So for those who are going to be here on the cement floor this winter, will help. Albina said that she has more and bigger size.
Okay, very good. Very good. Thank you, Marina. Other announcements? All right, very good. So let's listen to the life of the saint, then we'll come and receive our end of door, and we'll hear the thanksgiving prayers after communion as we do that.
The holy apostle and evangelist Matthew, also named Levi, was one of the 12 apostles and brother to the apostle James. He was a publican or a tax collector for Rome in Galilee, the city of Capernaum. Publicans who collected taxes from their countrymen for Rome and took large cuts for themselves were considered by the Jews to be the traitors of their country and religion, and the word publican often was used to describe public sinners or those who were considered, or had a connotation of those who were public sinners. When Jesus Christ was preaching in the street, he told Matthew, "Come follow me," and Matthew left everything and followed the Savior. Christ and his disciples accepted Matthew's invitation to his house, where they shared a table with the publican's friends, who were also publicans, and known sinners, which disturbed the Pharisees and scribes greatly. Matthew, repenting of his greed, repaid anyone he had cheated of money fourfold and gave his remaining possessions to the poor, then went after Christ with the apostles. He was a witness to the suffering and death and resurrection of the Savior and his glorious ascension into heaven. Having received the grace of the Holy Spirit which descended upon the apostles on Pentecost, St. Matthew preached in Palestine for several years at the request of the Jewish converts at Jerusalem. The Holy Apostle Matthew wrote his gospel describing the early earthly life of the Savior before leaving to preach the gospel in faraway lands. The Apostle Matthew preached among many people who are awaiting the Messiah. His gospel manifests itself as a living proof that Jesus Christ is the Messiah foretold by the prophets and that there would not be another. The Holy Apostle brought the gospel of Christ all the way from Persia to Ethiopia, covering over 6,500 kilometers on foot, where he was eventually martyred. One day in Ethiopia, the Holy Apostle was fervently praying to God for the conversion of the Ethiopians. The Lord appeared to him and gave him a wooden staff, commanding him to plant it at the doors of a church. When he did, the staff grew into a great fruit tree. And as the Ethiopians washed themselves in the water and ate the fruit, they abandoned their pagan ways and were converted. When the Holy Apostle carried the staff towards the church, he was met by the wife and son of the ruler Fulvian, who were possessed by demons. In the name of Christ, the Holy Apostle healed them, converting many witnesses to the Lord. Fulvian, fearing his subjects would abandon the pagan religion, accused the apostle of sorcery and gave orders to execute him. They put St. Matthew's head on brushwood and lit a fire. The fire flared up but did not harm St. Matthew. Then Fulvian gave orders to add more wood to the fire, and enraged, he commanded them to set up 12 idols around the fire. The fire melted the idols and flared up towards Fulvian. The frightened prince turned to the saint and begged for mercy, and by the prayer of the martyr the flame went out. The body of the Holy Apostle remained unharmed, and Matthew departed to the Lord. Fulvian, having repented of his deed, still had doubts, and he commanded to put the body of St. Matthew into an iron coffin and throw it into the sea, saying that if the God of Matthew would preserve the body of the apostle in the water, he would, as he preserved him in the fire, then he would believe. That night, the apostle Matthew appeared to the bishop Platon in a dream and commanded him to go with the clergy to the shore of the sea and find his body there. The righteous Fulvian and his retinue went with the bishop to the shore of the sea. The coffin was carried by the waves and taken to the church built by the apostle. Fulvian begged for forgiveness of the Holy Apostle Matthew, after which Bishop Platon baptized him and gave him the name Matthew in obedience to a command of God. Soon Fulvian Matthew abdicated his rule and became a presbyter, later becoming a bishop after the Holy Apostle appeared to him and directed him to do so, thus continuing the work of the great evangelist.
Given the timing of St. Matthew's commemoration this year and all the troubles in Ethiopia, perhaps it would be good for us also this week to remember the people there who are suffering from the war in our place. Now, brothers and sisters, let's come and receive the Antidote and listen to the thanksgiving prayers of communion. Those who partook to thank God for the great gift, those who did not, to ask God as they really suffered to help them partake.
Lord, my God, that thou hast not rejected me as sinner, but thou hast vouchsafed me to be a communicant of thy holy things. I thank thee that thou hast not, but thou hast vouchsafed me to be not. Thou hast saved me the money for taking thy most pure time of gifts. But if thou, Master, Lord, may have come before our Savior's lot, his dying rise again, and his promise these dying will be a ministry for clothing and sanctification of our souls and bodies, that the deeds may be even unto me for healing both soul and body, for the averting every thing of self, the enlightening of my eyes and my heart. For the peace of the power of my soul, for faith and shame, for love and faith, for the fullness of wisdom, for the giving of thy commandments, and for the increase of thy divine grace, for the kingdom of thy kingdom, that being preserved by them in thy holiness, I may remember thy grace and no longer live for myself, but be a master or benefactor, and thus when I shall depart this life and hope of thy eternal, and may be an everlasting rest, for the sun of them that is festival of unceasing, and the light of them is unending. And if the wise and rest of them that will hold me up obedient thy countenance, that up true desire, and the immortal gladness of them that love thee, by surviving all the creation is in thee, amen. Thank you.
give someone to have questions to brought to fire to consume the words
from God our Creator, for I
sent it out of my members, my joints, my reins, my heart, for I hold forward to my sin, for all my soul, sanctify my thoughts, strengthen my substance, together with my bones, and my simple five senses, kneel down the hold of me with thy fear, ever protect, preserve, and keep me, and my soul corrupting thee even word, purify and cleanse and adore me, and be coming, and understanding what is like me, show me thee. And the dwelling place of thy spirit alone, and no longer with the habitation of sin. That for me is thy oath, the entry of thy communion, every evil doer, every passion, may please from fire, as intercession, as intercessors I offer unto thee, all things, the commanders, the bodiless hosts, that order of the wise apostles, and through the land of undefiled pure mother, whose entreaties do thou accept in compassion of Christ, and make thee servant, make me thy servant, child of light, so that our Lord our sanctification of the one. And to the east of our souls, and he is God in us, we set up all glory, and visit me every day. Consolation, my joy, and thou especially, deep wisdom, worthy, to be our taken and most purifying in the precious blood of thy Son, that thou who gave us birth to the true life, that thou might my spiritual eyes and my heart, thou who gave us birth to the source of immortality, revive me from the dead in sin, thou art the loving, compassionate mother of a merciful God, have mercy on me, and grant me compunction and contrition in heart, and humility in my thoughts, all my thoughts from captivity, gosh, take me in my last breath to receive thy commendation. Of thy most grievous grief, the healing of the close soul and body, and grant me tears of repentance and confession, all work of peace, with which to end and glorify thee in all the days of my life. And bless earth thou, which is broken out beyond the age of these times.
The world and treasures of uncovetedness, you've shown us the heights of humility, so I'm instructing my words, O Father John Chrysostom, your servant, the word of Christ our God, to save our souls.
честнейший Херувим, славнейший без сравнения Серафим, без истления Бога Слова Росшую, сущую Богородицу Тебя величаем. Слава Отцу и Сыну, и Святому Духу, и ныне пресно, и во веки веков они. Господи помилуй, Господи помилуй, Господи помилуй, благослови.
Spread of the disease so we can get back to the